lay me there with a barrel of beer and a cup in my right hand, and over me coffin sing this cheer.
One cannot make an omelette without
Kingfisher. Where do you get the name?
Master Dandelion's poetry. The kingfisher preened, then fell in the latrine. Know it?
Yeah. Also know the one about Princess Annie, who drowned in the River Fanny.
Yes. At any rate, the kingfisher welcomed poetry lovers with open arms. Some of the brightest stars in the literary firmament performed here.
What are you serving today? Looking for a partner. Wouldn't mind a round of Gwent.
Then you're in the right place, friend. If you'll play now, I'll stake the unique card from my collection.
Sure, let's play.
Okay, this is the first time I've ever... Really? That sucks. There's nothing I want to play. I don't want to go first. Gonna get such a kicking. Yes, sir. Give me a spy, please. Ah, oh, you son of a bitch. Wait, no. good. I win. No, I don't. Cancel that. Let's just do that. See how much I lose. Yeah. I lose. This wasn't even close. Say no, you suck balls. Oh, I should have kept that. No, I didn't. A grave hag. I lose. Well, I'm gonna play him again, and I'm gonna kick your ass. Yeah, I would have too if I had a different hand.
How can I be of service?
Yeah. Well.
So, shall we play?
Yeah,
sure. Let's play.
Hopefully I don't draw a shitty deck. And... gee, what am I, a weather control specialist? God. Keep biting frost. Perfect. Yay. Even more yay. Small victories, I guess. I wish I had my dragon, dude. All right, he played himself out of cards.
You win. Card's yours.
I think I got Triss. This is a card he played that was a unique one. Tibor Egrek. Why am I getting a look up? Never mind. Oh, what was I doing? Okay, so you got your quest markers. Same players. Following the thread. I'm not ready to go back there. I'm not ready to go there. I'll probably go talk to that dude. Such a high level, I won't get anything from it. The sooner I get it done, the better.
Just passing by, wanderer? Or do you seek something specific?
Who's asking?
Rudolf de Jonquier. Of those de Jonquiers, yes. My ancestors laid the foundations of this city. I now own its largest bank.
Didn't need a recommendation. Name would have been enough.
Father always said, all ought to know your merit, son. Don't hide them under a bushel.
I'm looking for Corinne Tilly.
You've come to the right place, then. Corinne is inside. Been there for a few days, dreaming the home's history.
Not interested in what's going on inside? Seeing it for yourself?
I'm a banker. Cursed homes scare me. Do you know how a haunting can affect property value? Point of fact, Corinne requested she not be disturbed.
Why do you need to know the house's history? You a historian, or on a whim?
I bought this property a short while ago. Paid a pretty penny, I might add. Soon after, I witnessed disturbances. Led me to fear the home might be haunted.
What are the symptoms?
Oh, they vary. Giggling in the night. And furniture moving about in the attic. And last week... Well, you shan't believe it. I found human feces in the parlor.
I'd like to go inside, look around.
I don't usually let strangers rummage around my home. Twin swords, though. You're a witcher. You may enter, call that my whim.
The second sword, is it in case the first one breaks? Smart.
I don't care. I'm looting everything.
Put it down, please. That's blood. Don't spill it. Please.
Huh.
Stop. Go away. Leave it!
Well, I did say that she's dreaming. That's not the silver sword.
Wake up. It's just a dream. Wake up.
Oh. The doll. The attic.
All right. Time to check the attic.
Put it down, please. That's blood. Don't spill it. Please.
Right after I take it.
Stop. Go away. Don't do that. Leave it.
Way to the attic. Get magic abilities called signs. You have Fusroda, or Ard, excuse me. A cursed circle that slows enemies down. Shoot fire. Force field. And mind control.
Second floor. Wonder what'd happen if I laid a doll in it.
Stop! Go away! Leave it!
I'm gonna go check in the basement.
Thank you.
another masterpiece. An oven and a blackened grate. Oh joy, a riddle. Saw an oven in the cellar. Maybe I'll find another clue there.
Did I scare you? Scared you, didn't I? I can tell you was scared. Big brave man scared of wee little Sarah. Ain't that funny?
I wouldn't do that anymore if I were you, Sarah. You might scare someone so bad they'll hurt you.
Why would someone hurt me? Having a spot of fun's not allowed anymore.
What are you playing?
That lady fell asleep, and I've sent her some horrible dreams. I'll not her wake neither. I can do that, you know. Funny, isn't it?
Very funny. Thing is, I gotta talk to the dreamer, so I'd like you to let her wake up.
Little Sarah doesn't want her to wake. Little Sarah wants to play.
You're lucky. I know you're a harmless godling, but others might not know, and then...
And how'd you know I'm a godling, eh? How's that, eh? Eh?
If it looks like one and acts like one, trust me. You're a godling. You give the dreamer nightmares and won't let her wake up. Why are you tormenting her?
I'm not tormenting anyone. Scary dreams are great. What I love is when this big hen chases me. Hen's got this red...
Why do you live in a haunted house?
Tell you the secret. The house ain't haunted. Not one bit. I just pretend it is. Make everyone think that. It was sitting there all empty. So I moved in. Bigwig from the bank then came and bought it. I don't like bankers, especially not to live with, so I decided to give him a scare.
Gave the banker a really big scare. See, he paid a lot for this house and won't give it up easily, which is why you need to find another home.
I don't want to! I don't! I won't!
Sarah, Novigrad's no place for a godling. But if you want to live here, that's your business. So let's make a deal.
A deal? What kind?
Leave the dreamer alone. In exchange, I'll tell the banker the house is haunted. For good, no way to lift the curse.
You tell him that? What if he doesn't believe you?
I'm a witcher. He'll believe me.
Yes? 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 Do that, and I promise not to bother your friend. Not even a little. You're awfully nice, you know.
I don't hear that often. Thanks.
Now go wake that sleepyhead. I won't stop her. She'll get up.
Who are you?
Triss Merigold sent me to see you.
Gods. Horrible nightmares. I was supposed to dream the history of this house. Instead, I saw furniture. Hungry furniture that wished to devour me. I know it must sound foolish. But in the dream... Well, it was all too real. And not at all amusing.
The work of a godling. She made people believe the house was haunted. Also injected your dreams with her little jokes.
And you managed to wake me. I feel fortunate.
We witchers have our ways.
I thank you very much. The dreams, they were awful. Any way I can pay you back?
There is, actually. I'm looking for a young woman who was seen in Novigrad.
I can certainly try to help. But I'll need to clear my head first. After those deranged dreams, I feel it's full of cobwebs. Find me at the Golden Sturgeon. I rent a room there.
All right. See you there.
Meant to do that. Yeah. Totally.
I saw Miss Corrine leave, but she refused to speak to me. Is the matter resolved, or quite the opposite?
A bit of both. A demon had captured Corrine. I managed to free her, but the house is still haunted.
Did Corrine dream of the buildings past?
Yeah. Pretty horrid, apparently. Though she refused to talk about it. Nobody should inhabit the place.
So many crowns I paid!
Oh, well. It shan't put me in the poorhouse.
Truth is, we're already dependent on the black bottoms, economically.
I don't work...
I beg your pardon.
Never mind. Whatever. Even if I was just investigating, you know, pay.
Whee!
Something sharpened, reforged.
What do you have on offer?
It just went completely silent. It's kind of creepy.
You do well not to pester folk. I'm just trying to figure out. Suddenly, oh, there they are. Okay, so now it's 5 a.m. People are running around. Let's have a gander, see if the blacksmith is in. Yes, he's in. Weird. Incredible, so what a few seconds will do.
Hey, pretty boy.
Need something sharp.
What do you have?
Well, let's get him to fix our crap. Well, let's see if there's anything worth dismantling. $116 to break that apart? That's ridiculous. This guy's expensive. Huh, wax. All right.
Wouldn't mind a few rounds of cards.
I'm probably gonna lose this one. It's not gonna be playing any spies. So double the strength of everyone in that row. Wonderful. Kinda wish I had my Scorch now. Heck, even a Fighting Frost and I could wipe out that entire line. Oh well. Let's see. That's not what's in the card, though. Perfect. he plays nothing but a bunch of hero cards, I can't really do much against that. I win! Yay! That was a gamble. I've got 20 crowns and a cockatrice. Nice.
Welcome! Welcome!
What have you got there?
Just doing a little bit of selling. No, that's not bad. I mean, it's not as much as I'd want for it, but at the same time, it frees up a lot of space. I have so much Dwarven spirit right now. It's not even funny. The Redanian Nurgle. Yeah.
So long.
Okay, so there's like, you know, you walk into a room, no loading screen, which is kind of nice. Oh, you must be under. Alright, the only way to get down there is to go back down. Oh, she's upstairs. Upstairs. Read the little arrows.
A dream in here.
Never witnessed a seance like this before, let alone participated.
I will guide you. You must first achieve a kind of mental accord. I must ask some questions. You must answer them. It's important you're truthful. Answer from your heart.
Your gift. Tell me how it works.
It's hard to describe. To start with, I must gain an understanding of the bond between the person and the object I'm to dream about. I ask questions, try to flesh out feelings, emotions. Truth is essential in this. And though most who come to me acknowledge that, many refuse to speak openly of certain matters. Apart from which, they remain unaware of others, further obscuring things.
What do you see in your dreams?
I don't. It's my client who sees. My gift lies in summoning the right dreams. At times, nightmares or strong desires impose themselves on true events. It takes skill to separate seed from chaff.
Let's begin.
To start with, tell me a memory you have of this woman.
What for?
Do as I ask, please. I need the strongest, most complete memory you have of...
Ciri. The woman's name is Ciri. I accepted a job once. Did it. Asked to choose my reward, I invoked the law of surprise. Never thought I'd actually meet the child promised to me at that time. Years later, I was in the Broccolon Forest. Happened on a girl there, didn't know who she was. The Dryads wanted to keep her, turn her into one of their own. But the Waters of Oblivion, they failed in her case. Ciri came out of Broccolon with me. I sent her back to her grandmother then. But already, I felt bound to her.
By destiny?
By something more.
Thank you. Would you be willing to share another memory?
Yes.
No need to rush. We have time.
Ciri was orphaned during the Second War with Nilfgaard. Had no idea what to do with a young girl. So I did what I would have done with a boy, and took her to Kaer Morhen. Figured some physical training, sword work, development of her stamina, couldn't hurt. I remember her standing on a crumbling wall. A stone came loose, she lost her footing. Caught her at the last possible instant. Strongest memory, though, is of her coming out of her room one day, wearing a dress, and claiming she was indisposed. Knew then that Ciri was maturing. It was unavoidable. I was lost in the face of that.
I see. Do you wish to tell me anything more?
Yes, I think so.
In that case, I'm listening.
It was after her time training at Kaer Morhen. After the moment when Yennefer first called Ciri her daughter. We'd been separated. I knew she was in danger. I dreamt of her multiple times. I found her at Stygga Castle. She'd gone there to free Yen and gotten herself captured in the process. They wanted to hurt her. I remember fighting side by side with Ciri on stairs slippery from blood. It was the first time she ever deflected a crossbow bolt with her sword. Told her never to try it again.
These memories, they're intense. Do you wish to continue?
I have more to say.
Then please do.
It was in Rivia. The Second War with Nilfgaard had just ended. There was still tension in the air. For gods know what reason, race riots erupted in the town. I tried to do something, but couldn't stop a riled crowd. A boy with a pitchfork. He ran it right through my gut. Yennefer lay dying as well. Ciri had us carried onto a boat. We sailed to a place where apple trees bloom eternal. She left us there. It was the last time I saw her.
You claim the woman has abilities.
Tell me about them.
She's a child of the Elder Blood.
A descendant of Bloody Falker. The rebel burned at the stake. The prophecies claim the world's destroyer will be born of the Firebrand's cursed blood.
Pure legend.
No one in legend transforms into prophecy when it gains believers. I think you're right to be reticent in talking about the woman. I see. Do you wish to say more?
Yeah, there's something else. They call Ciri the Lady of Space and Time. Once I asked Yennefer why, she travels between worlds. Turns out I don't know how to talk about it. Didn't really understand much of what Yen told me. I just know there's more to it than traveling to different places, and that Ciri carries immense power in her blood.
I see. Do you wish to say more?
Yeah, there's something else. I remember Ciri having trouble controlling her abilities. Yennefer tried to teach her to cast simple spells, and Ciri destroyed a shed near the temple where they were. Really upset her, but it was just an old shed. I know it took her a while to gain control, and frankly, I doubt she controls her abilities fully to this day.
I see. Do you wish to say more?
No. Can we start?
Naturally. I knew you cared about her. But your tone, the emotions you so carefully conceal.
Let's continue, please.
Make yourself comfortable and try to relax. You must take my hand and talk of Ciri. Tell me where you think she might be. Who could be at her side?
If Ciri couldn't find me, I'm sure she would have looked for another friend.
Who do you mean?
Maybe Dandelion. They liked each other a lot. First. After that, just nightmares.
At times, the dreams can multiply. Show the past as well as the future.
The swallow. It symbolizes Ciri. She contacted Dandelion. I didn't know he was in town.
The poet? Heard about him. Someone left him the Rosemary and Thyme in their will.
The Rosemary and Thyme? Where's that?
As you enter the city through the Red Light District, you come upon a bridge. The Rosemary is just past it.
Dandelion inherited a brothel?
So I've heard.
Thanks for your help.
Good luck, Witcher. I hope you find your Ciri.
Tossing, tossing! sick.
That was ridiculously easy.
I, her, that's right, I, a woman, am captain. Shocking as shit, I know.
Need to get to Skellige.
Not on this boat, you won't.
Pay you well.
The islanders live off plundering the seas. Not willing to risk that.
Ever sailed there?
Listen, the islanders attack all ships. When they hate someone, Nilfgaard, for instance, they attack him more. But truth be told, not much more. Boarded me once. Expect they wanted to see if I had captain's bollocks. That spot of fun gave me enough Skellige for a lifetime. No leading our lasses astray, scum.
Got so fucked up, man.
What a smack!
Just a bit of drop
this. Oh!
Watch where you're
walking. What's the hurry, Mud Queen?
What happens when you don't pay attention to your stuff?
I'll never come back, you stinking scadgies! Next time I'll rip your fucking legs off and shove them up your ass till you've toes for teeth!
Ah, Zoltan.
Gear up in the nick of time, as always.
Zoltan, with your boot to someone's ass, as always. Who were those men?
Local color. I wasn't going more than a moment. Long enough for them to turn our home into theirs. All right. Time for some spring cleaning. I've got to boot them all out. Care to join me?
With pleasure.
Ready, big boy?
Tight around him! Gotta get around him! Yeah.
Shut up and fight.
Reminds me of a piece of floor.
Yeah, almost like we never left Virgin.
Oh, please. That went well. Now we can greet each other like the gods of the ages.
Hey, Zoltan. You look good.
Training plenty lately. What with the war on, no Mahakaman meat to be found, but Redanian lagers standing in just fine. You, though, you've withered a bit. Something worrying you?
Got some problems. Rather not burden you.
Fuck off, Geralt. Need to spill your guts to me now.
I'm looking for Ciri. I know she came to Novigrad.
Ah, I didn't see the second dialogue option in time.
She's come back? I'll be damned. I wonder if I'd recognize her. How many years is it now? 6? 7? But what's she be doing here?
Hiding, probably. She might be in danger.
See her in your dreams?
Couple times. Her and the Wild Hunt.
Oh, not good.
Not at all, but I know she came here and contacted Dandelion.
We've a wee problem then.
There's a few things.
Let me guess. Triss? Yennefer, perchance?
Triss and I talked. Cleared some things up. As for Yennefer, well...
So you found her? Ha! Need to tell me all about it.
I will. Some other time. Got something a tinge more important to take care of now.
Meaning?
Where's Dandelion?
Ha! I'd like to know that myself. Maybe he can explain what the hell's going on. I just fell returned as you saw. Expecting to come home to a hot leg of boar and some cold ale, and what do you find instead? A shite storm! Dandelion gone, the tavern chock full of bums. I've no clue what happened.
Let's look around. Might find something that'll put us on his trail.
Prime idea. I say we start on the ground floor. It's where he sat and wrote.
Well, I'm gonna dig around in the stash a little bit, dump some runes. I've got so much crap, it's not even funny. is the only stuff weighing me down now, which is good.
Aha! A note from a grateful muse.
Reading someone else's letters.
My visage red and hot. I plunged...
The faculty of Oxenfurt University is honored to grant Julian Alfred Pancratz, Viscount de Letenove, the title of Master of the Seven Liberal Arts.
Keep forgetting he's got that damn fool name.
From the finest vineyards, every last one.
No one knows the fruit of the vine like Dandelion.
This is the loot he got from the elves of Dol Blathana.
Aye. Must have been in a great rush to leave it behind.
Of Toussaint Dry, 5 cases of sodden triple mead. Nothing here.
No, that's exactly what we're looking for. It says planner.
Seems Dandelion's taking the tavern business seriously.
If you only knew. Gives it everything. No seen him this obsessed ever. Seems when he inherited this fine establishment, it came with some fine responsibilities. Bookkeeping among them. He also made a habit of noting down the times of his meetings, official and private. So, who'd he been seeing of late? Ah, here it is. Seems he's only been meeting women of late, the dog.
Not a bad idea. Dandelion's pretty loose-lipped. Might have blabbed something to a lady friend that'll put us on his trail.
That's what I'm counting on. We should divide these somehow. Perhaps... Ah, fuck it. I'll ask the lassies in my half, you interrogate the ones in yours. Should you?
Zoltan, wait. This is in verse.
And you figure that's unnatural because...
Wonderful. Meet me back here when you're done. Share our findings.
Right, you are. Need to do a wee bit of tidying before I go. Cannot stomach the idea of coming back to this mess. And you'd be wise to read your bit before you scurry off. If you need anything, I'll be next door.
Still here? Looking for something?
Just checking to see that everything's in place. Buggers might have hauled something off for pawning.
Actually, glad you're still here. Wanted to ask you about someone. Though well she knows the touch of silk and lace, she shuns not straw when gripped in lust's embrace.
Molly keeps things tidy for the Baroness Lavalette.
A baroness within reach and he settled for a chambermaid?
Dandelion's not one to judge folk by their station. You know that. Like he says, in the alcove, we're all equals.
Yeah. Guess a true poet observes life in all its aspects, examines it from all perspectives. If I didn't know him better, I'd say he was jealous about this Mirabella.
Oh, I doubt it. Former pupil. And well, the tales he told me about her.
Doubt I want to hear them.
Probably better off not. Things between them took a turn for the strange at some point.
Meaning?
She had him wearing mummer's costumes. Took to calling him Christian, referring to herself as Anastasia.
Truly perverse.
He did a kind of half of it. Called him a stallion once. That's the fool took it as a compliment. Till she pulled a bit in the reins into her cupboard. Poor bastard fled out the window.
Vespula. Name rings a bell. She threw his knickers out the window.
That's her.
Hollered something about him being a scoundrel with a voice like a consumptive pheasant.
That's her.
Threw flower pots at him.
Guess soul flames never die.
Like a rose abashed of its crimson hue, fair Rosa would sink into humor's blue. She shunned her lessons in civility, to swing her dwarf with agility. Dwarf? Never suspected he'd be so humble.
Dwarf's what Rosa Var Atre named her Gwyhir. Well chosen, eh?
All right. But Var Atre? Her dad happened to be the Nilfgaardian ambassador?
Yes. You know him?
Wouldn't say that. Had a brief conversation with him at the palace in Vizima.
Well, then you've a good notion of the kind of bloke he is. Commissioned Dandelion to tutor Rosa and her sister in the art of rhetoric. But we Rosa preferred swordplay.
How dare she reject the great bard in favor of a common swordmaster?
More than one, it seems. Week on week, we get fresh gossip about her thrashing another instructor. So bad he resigns. Word has it her dad's now looking to hire her next victim. I mean, instructor.
A figure most rare, her nature dual. Look deep in her eyes or be made a fool. Well, well, seems fascinated with this one.
Not without reason. Never been much for elven women myself, but this one's exceptional. Dare say Francesca Finderbeard be jealous.
You want to take this one, then?
Nah, you can have her.
Why?
See, elven beauty's like a young Beauclair wine. Whereas I prefer vodka straight up.
Well, know about all I wanted to know. Thanks for your help.
I think I might want to go run in the swamps for a little bit. Broken Flowers, level 11. Actually, I'm going to go take care of this one first. And then I'm going to go take care of that creature in the woods.
No bread, no coin, poor as shite.
What village are you from?
Looking to make some coin, too.
Hey,
you've mistaken me for someone else.
You're the only one here who's made a mistake. Now stamp up some crowns, quick!
Leave him alone.
And who might you be? Temple guard undercover?
Call me an admirer of law and order.
Made a mistake coming to this town, eh?
You're making the mistake. Leave him alone.
And if we don't...
Stick my nose into it.
This man's not worth your efforts. His shop's drowning in debt.
You're right. Even looks like a pauper.
I beg to differ. Don't even know why I bothered the bugger. My apologies. Fare thee well.
I gotta go brush my teeth.
These are not the drawings you're looking for.
And try not to come round here anymore.
I will. I won't. I mean both, yes. Thank you, sir.
Looking to make some coin too, hey?
White one, take a gander.
Seems to me I've heard of you before.
My, what a freak.
This house, is it always been crooked?
Yeah, of course. They built it straight. Two men moved in, wanted to break into Vivaldi's manor. So, they dig a tunnel from the cellar of the house straight to the vault. But they were sorry miners. Didn't reinforce the tunnel. When that collapsed, the house went all crooked.
What happened, kid?
They...
Hey!
Hey, wait!
Coming back.
The Grey Git!
Grab him!
That would be stupid.
From the start. No men, no pets. 'Tis a decent house for decent folk.
Don't worry, won't stay long.
Not a gentlemanly caller. Also, a bunch of gits. Talk to you in a second, Triss. These people are rude. And they let you in, but I don't doubt that given an opportunity. Already, it's a lot of butter knives.
Yes, Geralt?
See, you kept the Rose of Remembrance I gave you in Flotsam.
Seems so long ago. Probably because so much has changed.
So, sentimental value. That why you kept it?
Partly. Though, more as a warning.
Been in Novigrad long?
Long enough to know how not to get caught and survive.
And before you came here, where were you?
Oh, places. Where I managed to get by without your help, too. Which doesn't mean I'm not happy to see you.
Look what I picked up.
Artifact compression. Someone got themselves enchanted in this figurine.
Intend to decompress?
Of course. Whoever cast the spell on the poor soul must have forgotten about him.
Looks like a nobleman.
Could be just that. Come with me. I can't perform the ritual here. Everything's ready. Let's get to work.
Place is pretty grim.
True. It looks like a vampire's hideout. Which is why we can be pretty sure no one will bother us here. Give me the figurine and stand back.
Let's try it. Think it's a nobleman.
Be on your guard. It could be something far more dangerous. In Aalen, Dwana ar Ice.
No! Carl, no! I can explain everything!
Coral?
I never looked at the lass. You are my one and only. Oh, you're not Coral. Some succubus. A delusion. Where am I?
So Coral enchanted him. Just like her.
If there's a more vindictive sorceress, I don't know her. Well, except maybe.
Coral's not here. In that case, come to me, succubus.
What is your name?
We're in Novigrad. Novigrad.
In Novigrad? Last I recall, I was in Oxenfurt, and Coral was furious. How can she demand fidelity when she herself is wanton as
youthful goats?
Exactly. Damn it! I feel as if I've been trampled by a herd of cattle. I've no notion what she did to me. But it seems you've delivered me from my misfortune. Here, take this. Have a good time. Paint the town Coral.
Whose taste has grown worse since you were sleeping with her. Come on, the kind-hearted gentleman will get along fine on his own.
That didn't get me very much. It's a little bit finicky about alignment, so.
it true, elves make soup out of...
Days, air-brained, all of them.
Whoa there, Roach.
My bloody old child didn't notice if his arse where he don't belong.
But a new race teach. You're a bigger rat picker than me.
Not good.
So, how do you go with this thing?
Oh.
Something about one of your own business, when suddenly, people...
Double shots. From now on, assume your every move's observed.
Some people, they don't like to fast travel when they go. I do not mind fast traveling.
Horses.
Do you not hear the huntsman?
Oh, I
hear about the contract.
Nay, but proper huge it must be. Slaughtered no less means malice rules it, makes it kill. Howls and bellows nights.
Could tend to the beast for you, but not for free.
How much do you need?
Appears I have a base rate of about 250 crowns.
That's a sum we can agree to.
Fine, I'll take care of it.
Fortune smiled upon us when it brought you here. Good hunting to ye!
Don't steal our youngins!
Where'd you come from?
Blame my parents. One of them was a sorceress.
Wiped out the whole pack.
Sure it wasn't me.
Big. Really big. A lot of fur when it rubbed against the trunk. Scent still there.
This is a chort.
A storm, damn it. Stinks like fiend shit. Right. Old and dried out. Fiend's been around a while.
Mandrake root. Yes, I'll take it. Some kind of cairn here. It says to me there's probably a hole in the ground. Work. Bork, bork, bork. Stop. You're doing me a frighten. Oh, there it is.
Recently. Wonder what killed it. Tufts of blood-caked fur. Second beast was a different color. Another trail. Tracks too small for a fiend, though. Paw prints. Fight lasted a while. Both lost loads of blood. But short, it's gotta be. Probably competed for territory with a fiend. Have to lure him here somehow. Dung's not fresh, but it ought to still work for a lure. Thank you. Detroit's attention. Smell this 5 miles away. Beast's sure to show. Just gotta wait in the cave.
Relict and Devil's Puffball. Let's see. Relict oil. Oh, I can't believe I haven't enhanced this yet. Devil's Puffball. And let's put the lantern back. Ooh! Holy shit. Let's see how this goes again. I had a good thing going, but kind of screwed it up.
Beast's sure to show. Just gotta wait in the cave.
I think it might be a little bit beyond me, but at this point I'm kind of stuck. I can't flee from the battle because I'm stuck in a room. So I can leave without having to fight it. Let's try one more time. Oh, that's why he keeps trying to counterattack, but he's in the middle of the thing. So this has some kind of... Okay. So it does have its limitations. Golden Oriole is what I need to take for this. It's affecting me.
Yeah.
That's cheap. I'm level 15, this is a level 20 monster, so that's why I'm not really dealing too much damage, why this is taking so long, and why I'm having so much difficulty with it.
Silver.
Well, that wasn't very easy. Well, given that half of it was in slowdown, but that's because of some potions that I took. But yeah, I also got a new trophy, a chort trophy, bonus experience for monsters, which I'm totally cool with. Let's see, what's this one? There it is, new one. Oh, right, alchemy. Let's see if there's anything I can make. No. Well, there's a decoction. Chort decoction. No stagger. Neat. Makes me tanky. I remember when I had to buy Dwarven Spirit. I didn't have patience. I'm just gonna meditate right here. Ugh. 'Cause I used up a lot of my stuff on that fight. Let's go back and get my monies.
Chort was prowling the nearby forest, found itself competing for territory with a fiend, so it turned aggressive.
A chort? Fiend? Why they be bothering us? Think more'll come? Think they've done made a pact to take our village?
Doubt it, but I'll be sure to keep my eyes open, see if there's anything else out there.
Cheers, then, Witcher. Here, take the purse. All the folk of the village chipped in.
Thanks. Take care now.
And now looking at my character screen, I could go out and kill monsters and get all the experience that I need to level up one more time. And basically fully develop my heightened tolerance perk. Perfect, so I can't overdose on my potions. Mutagen in there. Put the blue mutagen. I think I might put Undying on there. So it's like a pretty cool ability. Kind of want Whirl, but
got a lump of bread today.
Where'd you steal it from? Level neckers and the like. Go to that one spot. Oh, right. I could probably build some feline equipment.
Long live Radovid!
Hail Radovid.
Oof. Fuck.
I do that sometimes. Am I stuck? Yes.
You can't spread disease. Defeatism and aversion.
Fuck.
Oops. I don't know which side of the map that is. Is that... All right, that's where I wanted to go.
I will get you every last copper. With interest. Give me a week, please.
Horson's no banker. He's an honest man. You pay on time, you get protection. You don't pay...
Help!
What you hollering for, stupid wench? What are you hoping for? A knight in shining armor?
Close enough.
Keep out of this, Greyhead. Not your concern.
This coin and leave.
That ain't how it works. Vespula's to pay or be taught a lesson.
Already given her a verbal reprimand. Now go before I teach you a lesson.
Come on. Gold's gold.
Thank you. Oh, thank you. To think there are men who'll help a stranger out of the kindness of their hearts.
Not entirely out of kindness, and you're not entirely a stranger.
What are you? Oh, I know you. You're that witcher took Dandelion out whoring. Gerald, right?
Not Gerald. Geralt.
Oh. Dreadful sorry.
Explain something if you don't mind. You say I took Dandelion out whoring.
So he said. Claimed I was his one and only. But he fell in with the wrong folk. You and that dwarf who always looks like a cow licked him. Said you two were a bad example. Wine, women.
Song. He picked that habit up from us too. Gotta have a word with him. What do you think? Where could Dandelion be?
Probably out whoring.
That horse pheasant. That lying scoundrel.
Ouch. What did he do to get your goat?
Same thing as ever. Prize bullshitter came back, saying it was till death do we part this time. And no more than a week passed before I spotted him in Harborside, strolling with some trollop on his arm. 'Twas the last straw. All those questions about the washerwomen at the bathhouse, then this. I beat him black and blue and threw him out on his ear.
Dandelion ask you about other washerwomen? Not terribly subtle even for him.
Maybe he likes some sudsy.
Maybe. But what did he ask about, exactly?
Oh, this and that, really. What's it like at the bathhouse? Have I got any friends there? What are their working hours? I don't know. Maybe he's looking to hire one for his tavern. Maybe I got all in a huff for no reason.
This woman he was with in the harbor, who was she?
Claimed she was his niece from Kovir. Ha! Horvir, more likely. Corset so tight her eyes were popping out her head. His too, come to think of it. An artist or a whore, doesn't much matter as they're one in the same.
Thanks for your help. Listen, when I find Dandelion, anything I should tell him?
No. I mean, tell him he's a two-faced snake, but it would be nice if he dropped by.
Friend of Dandelion's, looking for Eliel.
You've come to the right spot. How might I be of service? Need something shortened? Patch your trousers, darn your socks.
You, Eliel?
Yes. Now pick your jaw up off the floor.
Sorry, I thought. Thought Eliel was one of Dandelion's girlfriends.
Oh, so it's that. Wait here. Any better?
So you are...
Eliel.
Did you and Dandelion... I mean... How did you two meet?
I met him one night in a tavern. He was blind drunk.
What happened?
What do you think? We spoke.
That's it.
I'm not sure what you're getting at. But I should make one thing clear. Men don't interest me. Told him that as well. Luckily, Dandelion's an open-minded fellow. We had a lovely evening. He became a loyal customer afterwards.
Oh, why not?
I know this is none of my business, but why do you...
Why do I dress up? As a child, I dreamt of becoming a Doppler when I grew up. I became a tailor instead. Discovered clothing. Costumes can express all the complexities of one's personality. I'm a Redanian countess one day, a dockside thug the next. That is true freedom.
Mm-hmm.
Have you never thought to become someone else? Even for a moment? Must be horribly boring being a witcher all the time.
I managed to stay interested. What did you and Dandelion talk about? He asked about anything in particular?
Let me think. Had an ordinary chat, really. Although, indeed, he did keep asking about Kalkstein. If Dandelion and I hadn't laid our cards on the table at the start, I might have suspected he had a history with the alchemist. He spoke like a lovesick beau. In fact, he desperately wished to meet with him.
Kalkstein's in Novigrad? Wouldn't mind seeing him myself.
You're too late, I fear. The witch hunters nabbed him recently, burned him at the stake in Hierarch Square. But as he perished, ooh, the goings on, impressive. Fiery beasts circled his pyre, then rose into the sky and exploded to form letters.
Really?
What did they spell?
Radovid sucks flaccid cock.
Right on, you Cockstein. That was so funny. Alright, this ends the stream.